again.
Alright. Call this meeting to order. Clerk of the board may have a roll call.
Freeholder Carter. Freeholder Estrada. Freeholder Granados.
Here.
Freeholder Hudak.
Here.
Freeholder Kowalski.
Here.
Freeholder Mirabella.
Present.
Freeholder Wright.
Here.
Vice Chairman Bergen.
Present.
Chairman Jallo.
Here.
Chairman, you have seven freeholders. Seven and a half freeholders present.
Thank you. Clerk of the board, may you please lead us into prayer and salute to the flag.
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will, and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk of the board, can you please read the statement of compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act?
Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey Statutes Annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015 in the Administration Building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2015 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. We will approve communication at next week's regular meeting for note. We'll call up for the agenda the Office of the Union County Prosecutor.
Good evening, Chair, members of the board, and special welcome to the newest member of the board.
Good evening. The
Prosecutor's Office has three resolutions on. I'll be happy to take any questions you may have.
Freeholder Mirabella.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Number two, first assistant, is looks like it goes back to the previous year for an increase. And so far into this year, I'm surprised to see that. But what can you explain the reason that we're going back there to increase an amount?
Those were actually bills that were incurred during that time period. We have a number of contracts with Trinitas Hospital for different types of services they provide. This particular one goes to adult victims of sexual assault. The monies that we pay for that contract with are out of a VOCA grant. It just so happened that we had excess monies in the grant. Trinitas is actually extremely cooperative with us that if they exceed the contract amount, which is typically based on what we anticipate the grant to be, they will simply take it as charity care. And in this particular instance, because there was money left over from the grant, they had rendered the services, we felt it was appropriate to come back before the court, before the board to ask for that increase.
Yeah, so this additional dollar amount is with $2,014 or $2,015?
$2,014.
All right, thanks.
Any other questions?
Have a good evening. Thank you.
All right. Department of Administrative Services, Chairman Albert.
Good evening, Chairman, members of the board. Department has five resolutions on for your consideration. I'd be happy to address any questions you might have.
Any questions from the board? With regard to number two, I'm assuming this is a no-bid contract.
Yes,
can you tell me why?
It's an EUS. It's a state requirement that all insurances are awarded EUSs.
Okay. Thank you. Any other questions? Vice Chairman.
Also on number two, Mr. Albert, we talked recently about possibly going out to bid to privatize some of the work at the stables. Would we still need this policy even if we go ahead with that plan?
I believe we would not. It's from July 1st to June 30th, and July 1, 2015 through the next year. We would not, but we would certainly be able to cancel and get a refund.
Thank you.
That were the case.
Any other questions? Okay. Thank you, Derek.
Thank you.
Department of Economic Development, Deputy County Manager William Reyes.
Good evening, Chairman. Freeholders, the Department of Economic Development has seven resolutions, and if I may, I would like to add a resolution relative to awarding a contract for the Workforce Investment Act Youth Employment and Training Consortium.
Thank you. Any questions? Freeholder Granados.
Thank you, Chairman. Can you elaborate on number two and also the resolution you just mentioned?
Sure. Number two, due to changes in HUD regulations with CDBG.
Can you speak more into
that? I'm sorry. Sure. Number two, is that better? Number two, due to regulations in our CDBG regs, Winfield Park will actually change from having, Winfield will go from having a sewer rehabilitation project that was slated to going to using those funds for an ADA accessibility project. Recently, there were some changes. We used to get, eligibility used to come from census tracts. Now they come from a different source, and so now Winfield had to change their project to be able to utilize those funds. So they just switched projects. Oh, and then the other one is we'd like to use $640,000 to serve out-of-school youth and in-school youths through a consortium, which will be led by the United Way and made up by nine other service providers, including New Jersey Chamber of Commerce Foundation, Urban League, Jefferson Park Ministries, Prevention Leagues, Community Access, Court-Appointed Special Advocates, Plainfield Action Services, and Rahway Community Action Groups to help 150 youths for training, job trainings, and even paying internships as well.
Providing employment opportunities for residents. Okay.
Absolutely.
Any other questions?
Yes. Will that include all of the youth from Union County, or is it limited to certain municipalities?
All Union County youths.
Any other questions from the board?
Oh, so the outreach, thank you, Chairman. So the outreach will be where will the outreach points be for this particular program?
It will be throughout Union County, but it would be for youth that qualify to qualify for the services. But it will be countywide, not just services.
I'm sorry, but where exactly would the program be housed?
It's through the United Way. So they partner with all the agencies that I listed.
Sure.
And they each will be able to do outreach from their own centers.
Okay.
So that's why it's such
it would be helpful for me just so, you know, because it's always good when we're talking about these programs. And I think they're wonderful in terms of the goals, in terms of getting people to work and assisting individuals, with English language skills. And I think that's tremendous. But it would be great for us to be able to go back so we know exactly, you know, where these locations are. And, you know, because people often say, how can a resident in Union or Linden or Garwood or Cranford, you know, gain access to these programs? So literally having that list of locations they can go to would be very helpful.
Absolutely. Will do.
That'd be great. Thank you. Any other comments, questions? Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me, Chairman. I apologize. I had one question regarding the Ashbrook project. It may be not quite directed to you, maybe to Director Sanchez. Just wanted to get a brief overview, because I'm sure questions will come up, because there's a big dollar figure attached. So just an overview of that project again.
Absolutely. Through you, Mr. Chairman. The Ashbrook renovation project is going to be for the renovation of all of our bunkers at Ashbrook, which we are going to be basically rebuilding them from a drainage perspective, as well as lining them so that we will not have any contamination with the rain waters and coming back up through the bunkers, which we do have right now. This will eliminate a lot of the maintenance after our rainstorms that we can continue to open up quicker and play, as well as maintain the bunkers for a longer period of time, which the longevity of the bunkers usually is about 10 to 15 years. We're looking at these bunker liners are going to actually extend the life of those bunkers to about 20 to 25 years. We're also going to be tackling, which is our major problem at Ashbrook, and maintaining it and keeping it open during major rainstorms, is we have three holes out there, which are 5, 14, and 16, which generally flood, which are the ones that lie right along the basically the swamp at Ashbrook. We're going to basically tackle that with the drainage, a new type of drainage, which is going to eliminate a lot of the water, standing water on the fairways, so that once the rainstorms do subside, basically the waters will recede quicker, and we can continue get the golf course open faster, as well as when the golf, it'll dry quicker, so we can maintain it better.
So this isn't just simply an investment in terms of maintenance of the golf course, but this actually potentially could lead to more revenue,
absolutely,
more tee times, more green fees, and you know, a more successful golf product over,
absolutely,
over the long haul.
Absolutely. Times are where we'd be closed for a day, day and a half. Now we would probably be open within hours.
Great. Thank you, Director. Thank you, Chairman.
And Chair, may I add something, Chairman?
Absolutely.
Through you. Thank you. Also, these are not new county dollars. These are previously allocated capital dollars that will be utilized for the project.
Freeholder Quast.
I'm guessing we don't need an environmental impact statement.
No. This is basically just taking, we're not going to be changing any levels of the fairways. We're staying at the existing basically ground levels that we're at. We're just adding new drainage into the fairways.
Thank you.
Any further questions from the board? Thank you. Thank you. Department of Human Services, Director Frank Guzzo.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. The department has three resolutions on for your consideration. I'd be happy to answer any questions you have at this time.
Any questions from the board? Can you tell us about number two?
I would be happy to do that. As you know, Mr. Chairman, this is one of your initiatives for the year, which is to make child care more affordable for more people in Union County. And as a result of that initiative, we have looked at the lead child care agency in Union County, which is 4Cs, and have developed a plan, I believe, that will meet the goal that you've had to make child care more affordable for more people in Union County. I guess one of the things that is important, and I think, I hope that each one of you may have the proposal in front of you. If you do not, I'll make sure, obviously, it's available in the next day or so. But in Union County, as an example, the average weekly cost of child care is approximately $234. And that's for center-based care, infant care, and about $185 for preschool. This means that a single parent with two children under the age of five would need to spend approximately $21,528 annually on child care. If this parent had a gross income of $40,000, she or he would not be eligible for the state's New Jersey Care Kids program, which means that they make too much money to fit into that parameter that they have for the state of New Jersey, which means they would not be eligible for any subsidy. So in essence, what this does is this program will make that affordable for those individuals that are just above that line but still need the assistance.
And by the math that you said, it's about 60% of their income would be required to pay health care.
That's
child care.
That's absolutely correct.
Right.
So, I hope that you have it. I think we included it. If not, I'll make sure it's there. And I know that with talking with the chairman, that Pat Minuti, who's the executive director, would be here next week to answer any other questions that the board may have. We're also going to look, in addition to providing a better gap for child care, we're also going to look to target some specific groups with part of those dollars. People that have catastrophic illnesses that would not qualify need help too, so we're going to target some dollars for that. People that are chronically on welfare and need to find jobs but may not qualify for those other subsidies. And lastly, victims of domestic violence. A lot of people come into the 4C's office, and while they need the assistance, they need the help, they just don't qualify because the incomes may be too high. So we're going to look at targeting some dollars for that and do an assessment as the year goes on and see how we can adjust it to make sure that we're reaching the most people and get the most benefit out of this.
So with this amount of money, how many people do we think we can service?
We estimate right now about 40 families, just depending on how the money is used, would be able to benefit this year from that money. $47,000 of it, by the way, out of the 50 that is, it goes directly into helping families. There's only a $3,000 admin fee that Four Seas is taking for that, which is very nominal at best.
Thank you. Any other questions?
Chairman, I just wanted just more of a comment than a
sure.
than a question. You know, just having to having a child in daycare, knowing very well the expense that's involved, and being fortunate enough to be in a household with two incomes, I can really appreciate this program, and I am very in awe of many parents who have to spend such a high proportion of their income to just try to get to work. I think this is a wonderful initiative that you have, and I hope we all can get out there and support it next week. I think it's a great
program.
Glad
you said that, Freeholder. If it works, maybe we can increase the amount.
I think at twice the price, it's worth the money.
Right. Right. Anything else? Vice Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to say that the proposal, the complete proposal, was distributed with the agenda packet,
right.
And it seems to be a very well thought out, very well planned project to try and make sure that the dollars focus on the what they're supposed to do. So it seems to be a great idea.
If I may, as humble as I am, I'd like to take credit for it, but I have to tell you that when we went to Pat Mnuchin's, he just ran with it, and the credit would go to her relative to developing this program.
Excellent job. Thank you.
Thank you.
Department of Public Safety, Director Andrew Moran.
Good evening, Chairman, members of the board. Department of Public Safety has two resolutions on for your consideration. I'd be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Now, the funding for both of these are grant funding, is that correct? Or is that just number one?
Yes, number one is funded through our County Homeland Security grant.
And then number two is the CEHA grant, right?
And two is accepting the CEHA award.
Is there any amount of county operating funds going into this, or is it just this grant funding?
Just grant funding.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Freeholder Granados.
Thank you, Chairman. For number two, can you expand on elective programs?
Certainly. This funding will allow us to inspect underground storage tanks, gasoline tanks that are at every gas station. Our inspectors in the Environmental Health Division of our health department go out and visit each gas station. They do a variety of checks to make sure that those tanks are inspected and working in good working order. They also inspect dry cleaners. They do spot inspections on landscaping.
Make sure that businesses aren't taking advantage of consumers, correct? With the gas tank inspections to make sure that it's on proper.
It's more the environmental impact of those tanks and making sure that the integrity of those tanks are intact.
Gotcha.
And that dry cleaners that use very dangerous chemicals or disposing of them properly or getting them properly. So.
Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you. Freeholder Hudak.
Thank you, Chairman. Good evening, Director. In regard to the Neptune training grant, which municipalities provide, Union County, because I know it's UASI, so it's regional, correct, in terms of the Neptune system?
Actually,
this is specifically Union County?
No, this the training is from Neptune.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was thinking it was the Neptune. I'm sorry. Confusion.
No, this is for a swift water rescue. It was one of the needs that was identified by our fire departments during the recent, Sandy storm and Hurricane Irene.
Do we have a list of, what departments will be involved? Is this just for our personnel? Is this for a countywide?
26 firefighters, all Union County firefighters. The agencies that are participating are from Elizabeth, Union, Cranford, and Rowan. But this program is more than just a training program.
Mm-hmm.
We're actually going to have 12 instructors that will be going through train-to-trainer. so they'll be able to pass this knowledge on and certify other fire departments and water rescue.
Sorry, I saw Neptune and I focused in on the wrong word. Thank you, Chairman.
No problem. Any other questions? Thank you, Director.
Thank you.
Department of Public Works and Facilities, Director Joe Graziano.
Good evening, Chairman, Freeholders. The department has three resolutions on tonight for your consideration, and I'll try and answer any questions you have.
Any questions? Seeing none, thank you, Devin.
Thank you, Chairman.
Office of the County Council.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Office of the County Council has eight items on tonight's written agenda, and with your indulgence, I would ask your consent to add one item, which would be a resolution authorizing the county manager to enter into a lease agreement and pledge agreement with the PGA for use of the Oak Ridge Park for the period of August 24 through August 31. This has to do with the bark lease.
Any questions? Seeing none, thank you, County Council. Freeholder sponsored resolutions. This time I'll ask committee. Freeholders have any additional resolutions to add? Freeholder Kowalski.
Yes, thank you, Chairman. I will have resolutions about Holocaust Remembrance Day for various organizations in Cranford and some Holocaust survivors.
Thank you. Anyone else? Freeholder Granados.
Thank you, Chairman. Freeholder Schrader is not here currently today, but talk to him in reference to being added on to number four. And then, Nicole, I may have a laudatory in reference to a Boy Scout.
Freeholder Hudak.
Chairman, as a result of discussions with the fiscal committee, we'll have some position control resolution for the next meeting.
Thank you. Anyone else? Or if you can just record that, I will have one as well. We have a need to go into executive session. County Council, can you please make your statement relative to the same?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Pursuant to the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act, public body may go into executive session for the purpose of discussing certain enumerated subjects. This board now wishes to go into executive session for the purpose of discussing attorney-client privilege communications, discussion of safety tactics protocol, and potential negotiations of collective bargaining terms and conditions related to the Union County Juvenile Detention Facility. The minutes of the executive session shall be separated from the minutes of the open public session. The minutes of the executive session, redacted as appropriate and necessary, shall be available in approximately 30 days. Clerk to the board shall retain the original minutes until such time as the confidential limitations have been removed, at which time they shall be made available. Upon the affirmative vote of a majority of the members present, the board may retire to executive session. Upon the board's return, given this is an agenda meeting, it will not take any formal action on the matters discussed.
May I have a motion to enter into executive session?
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, it was moved by Freeholder Mirabella, seconded by Freeholder Hudak. Clerk of the board, may I have a roll call?
Here. I mean, yes.
Freeholder Hudak?
Hi.
Freeholder Kowalski?
Yes.
Freeholder Mirabella?
Aye.
Freeholder Wright?
Yes.
Vice Chairman Bergen?
Aye.
Chairman Jallo?
Aye.
Chairman, you have 7 votes in the affirmative.
Excellent. We're now in executive. They moved by Freeholder Mirabella, seconded by Freeholder Hudak. Clerk of the board may have a roll call.
Freeholder Granados?
Yes.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Different voice. Freeholder Kowalski?
Yes.
Freeholder Mirabella?
Aye.
Freeholder Wright? Yes. Vice Chairman Bergen?
Yes.
And Chairman Jallo?
Aye.
Chairman, you have 7 votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. County Council, is there any statement you need to make relative to the executive session?
I do, Mr. Chairman. As a result of the discussions had, if we are in a position to identify hirees, we may have an additional resolution relative to residency waivers.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
May I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved. Second.
Moved by Freeholder Granado, seconded by Freeholder Mirabella.
Aye.
All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.